Statue Hunter 75 here with an awesome statue from Kotobukiya. I've been waiting for this bad boy for a long time, and it's from one of my favorite sculptors, Erick Sosa, and he did an amazing job. I love the statue. He did the first Deadpool I ever got, which was from Bowen Designs. Erick Sosa also sculpted that. This is just a great piece. I love it. Love the base. The base is so highly detailed and just really cool. A lot of add-ons. I'll go through everything with you and tell you all about it. Just wicked cool. Give you a few spins around first to see the Merc with the mouth. Deadpool's pretty much my favorite character from Marvel Comics right now. Love Deadpool. Can't wait for the movie. Hope that still happens with Ryan Reynolds. Another thing is Sideshow Collectibles still has not made a Deadpool statue yet, which has really got me upset because I'm waiting for them to do a premium format Deadpool. I don't know how they would pull that off, but it would be pretty amazing if they did. But this is number 121 of 2000. Got a nice low number. I got a sweet deal. I got it from cornerstorecomics.com to the mail. Shipping was relatively cheap. I think it was like $12. And I think I only paid like $130 for this or something like that. It retails for like $175 on Kotobukiya's site. Alright, let's start getting into the details of it. Wade Wilson here, the Merc with the Mouth. I'll try to stay in focus. You know, I'm back to doing the videos again. This is a magnet. He actually comes with two switch out hands. There's two arms with katanas and two arms with Uzis. So I didn't, for the purpose of the video, I only have these two sets of arms because this is pretty much the only way I want to display them. I like them like this with the Uzi pointing and then the sword ready to slash right behind. So basically you can see the magnet. It's a nice firm magnet, works pretty good. Holds in pretty good, no complaints there. And there's, I don't know, it doesn't look too bad. The crease, actually it looks pretty good. I got no complaints about it, how the arm separates. Now the other arm doesn't separate here, it separates at the wrist. So there'd either be there's a small hand with an Uzi or a small hand with the sword. This magnet, however, it works, but it's a little loose, but it's still strong enough. And it looks nice. I know in the prototype video of this, people were worried because the sword looked kind of bent and it didn't look right with his arm, but it looks just fine. They fixed everything. Erick did an amazing job on this, even down to Kotobukiya's paint. They still gotta work on their paint job a little, but the shading on this is amazing. This is probably the best painted Kotobukiya statue I've seen to date. One thing I would just mention, he was really tough to get in. You had to position him perfectly. Otherwise, it felt like you had to pull his legs apart. You had to really tweak it. But I got him on good, no problems. My one, if you wanna call it a complaint, the only flaw I found with the statue was this right here. This little spot of paint. I don't even know if it's gonna stay in focus. Let me try and get in focus. There we go. This little spot of paint right there where my fingernail is. Little black there over the red. They kind of messed up on that. Kotobukiya is still working on their paint game, but other than that, it's not that bad. He looks great. I mean, the base looks awesome. So let's talk about the base. First off, this is loose, this little gun, which is pretty cool. Nice Glock or whatever it is. Someone's probably gonna correct me. That's a Beretta or Desert Eagle, whatever it is. This is part of the base. This is obviously the base right here. And this is connected to the base. This is connected to the base. The plush guy is loose. It's really cute. It's funny. I'm not sure if they got this idea from... it's hilarious, the two little swords. But I'm not sure if they got this idea from... the sculptor, I forget his name, but he did a sculpture of Mary Jane Watson, Spider-Man's girl. And at the bottom of the sculpture was a little plush Venom doll. Oh, look at that. In his eyes, there's little dots. Kind of maybe looking like it's a button. I don't know if you can see that. Let me try and... Yeah, you can see it, right? The four dots on that eye. So it's like a button sewn in for the eye. And then the other eye's squinting. That's really cool. I don't know, man. If you didn't get this statue, you're missing out if you're a Deadpool fan. You gotta pick it up. This gun is loose. Let me try and get it out without knocking everything over. This is like a M16 or something. It looks awesome. Or M4. You know, I'm not much of a guns and ammo nut. I mean, I play all the Call of Duties, but someone will probably correct me on what gun this is. It said in the instructions, actually. It comes with an instruction, like, little pamphlet telling you all the parts that it comes with and stuff. So you can just lay that down there. And then you have the little bullets. Let me try and get a focus here. The little bullet casings. That's really cool. They're scattered throughout the whole thing. And just the detail and the grain and the cement and everything looks really good. They did a great job. And this bazooka is loose as well. I know that's a bazooka. It's kind of a pain to get. Huh? There we go. Got it sitting there. If you fit it into that little crevice, it won't slide. So you can just leave it there at his foot. Look at his boot. I don't know if we got enough light, but I see his boot. Not really much tread marks on the boot. They didn't go into too detail at the bottom. It looks good, but good enough. There it is. You can kind of see it. There's the other foot. And of course, his trademark knife on his leg. I think he sculpted him pretty much with the same exact costume as the Bowen Deadpool. I like this costume a lot with the red dot there. I think this is a good traditional Deadpool costume. Let's look at the face on Wade here, on Mr. Wilson. Let me move his arm so I can get in good at the face, how he's squinting. I really like that. I love how Sosa does Deadpool. Like, it looks like he's sucking the mask in, like breathing in. You can see kind of like his mouth and his jaw. His eyes squinting. You can see his ears. And I'm glad he included the little lip hanging over on his kind of hood kind of thing. Love that. Erick Sosa does great sculpts of Deadpool. Well, he does great sculpts in general. Let's put that arm back on now that we got a good look at Wade's face. As you can see, the magnet works fine and the arm looks great. The ab sculpt looks pretty good too. Sorry for the darkness, it's kind of dark. Love the belt with the Deadpool eyes. It's good stuff. It's just an amazing Deadpool piece. If you don't have it yet, you might want to pick it up if it's still available. I'm sure it's going to sell out soon. Look at what the Bowen Deadpool is going for. Let me slide him a little closer and I'll show you the box. I showed you up top how it said 121 of 2000. The side kind of just says Deadpool in white. Can't really see it. And then the back of the box is kind of just like the Kotobukiya Hulks. The back of the box is... Let me zoom in a little for you. Actually, let me get this in focus. So you can read it if you want. As you can see, I love that Heisman stance cover. That one's great. Gives a little stats on Wade Wilson. And then there's other products. The Wolverine statue, also sculpted by Erick. That's the Danger Room Sessions fine art statue. There's a little bio on Erick, a little commentary on the sculptor, Erick Sosa. And oh, that's another thing I forgot to talk about. I love how the base, also on the box, it says Property of Deadpool. They added that kind of last minute. A lot of these, the original prototype was just this box and the base, I think a few shell casings. But he added that, he added the guns and the bazooka and the little plush toy. Just all around great stuff. Erick Sosa nailed this. Erick, if you watch this, you did a great job on the statue. I highly recommend it to anyone who's a Deadpool fan. Even if you're not a Deadpool fan, you should just get it just to get a fine piece of art here. It's a great sculpture. Good work, Erick. And I don't think anyone should have any complaints about the statue whatsoever. Maybe a little paint mishaps. But other than that, I mean, come on. Nothing in this life is perfect. But this is pretty damn close to it for Deadpool. Alright, have a good night, YouTube.